as you can see, the corn is going to be blocking the view of the railroad tracks. It's that high. It's June 23rd, 2015. Yesterday it looked so small. It looked like fire around here. It was so misty. I didn't smell fire, but it was smoky all across in the distance. And it wasn't real hot. It got kind of cool after it rained, cooled off a little bit yesterday afternoon, evening. But won't be able to see the trains going to the West Coast to get those illegals back over this way. So this summer is going to be the summer of rage. I don't care what anybody else says. It will be the summer of rage. What you do with that is entirely on you and your family. I'll do whatever I can to keep myself and my family safe and protected. Not leaving these premises. I'm not going to no jail. I'm not going with any thug with a badge. Whether it be the county sheriff. I don't even care if it's the sheriff's police. They need to leave me alone. This is where I live. I don't bother anybody else. I try to tend my garden with food for my wife and I and my pets. And I will die before I go. So I got this camera up high so that you can see over the corn there. That's, you know, I just caught that. I had the camera out here and I figured I might as well videotape it because I've been out here planting some more squash. So it's June 23rd. There's one of my little heathens out here. June 23rd, 2015. Let me see if I can see the time now. God bless it. It's 11:35 a.m. Okay, I just put in two squash in here because my emperor beans are not growing. Planted down here. I don't understand why they were sowed in here with fertilizer and watered in with a little bit of potting soil. And others come up. Now, I put in a buttercup squash over there and a buttercup squash closer to me in this aisle than a straight buttercup, and I forget the other one. Oh, golden buttercup, like which is out in the other garden. That's garden number one. This is number two. It's about 15 feet north to south by about 20 feet east to west. Jackson bean plants are growing okay. Two of them I put down here. They're growing out all right. We got honeydew melons. We got a couple on there already. We got some elongated watermelons and the far plant and four of those honey sugar baby round ones, almost like a big bowling ball almost. Beans, we had cutworm. I've got a couple of them off. The leaves have been decimated a bit. I've been looking at them. I don't see anything else. Cucumbers are still coming out. Tomato plants, where I had the cutworms, the first one and the third one on this second row in here. As you can see, the tops of the plants, the leaves are off of them. Not so much on the first one, but that third one there. Again, I can't see on this viewfinder, but you can see it somewhere in there, the third one. Let me go right here so you can see first and third. Again, I can't really see. I see images, but I can't make out which one. I think that's the third one there. See, there's no leaves on the top parts of the stems. Got coffee grounds all around the tomatoes. You know, a little after the fact type of deal as we're going, working as we go along. And I put coffee grounds around these other two, I believe, the tomato plants right here, there, and that third one back there somewhere. And I got peppers over here. Two we grew from inside the house. It is about 26, 28 inches. The first one here, and that one there is about, I'd say about 20 inches tall, the second one. Couldn't even tell you the type of tomato plants. I got so many different types. I got them in the house growing here. Like I said, those three, those little tiny ones I got from in the house. The four in the second row are from Kmart. All right, so it's gonna be a hot one today. So I'm trying to get all this done. I should have got this done about 6 o'clock this morning, but you know, I wake up around 5:30, quarter to six sometimes, and I don't get out here till 6:30, 7 o'clock. And with the heat and being not awake, the best I can do right now. Everybody, go get some food. You're gonna need this one day. I'm sorry to say, but I believe you really sincerely are gonna need it. If you can get a cooler, you can put like two tomato plants in there. You know, grow them from seed, get them from seed, you know what's in it. of them each day. Peppers over here. It gets like, say about 50% sun. In the morning it gets a little sun, then later on this evening you see how it's like shaded a little bit, and sun, as the sun sets in the west out back, you'll get sun over here a little bit more. They did good for the last 3 years over here, and we didn't have as many over here. We had probably about 12 back here, or 7 back here before. Now we have 19. So of these 19, I would say at least 15 to 16, 17 will grow to be full-size pepper-producing plants. So anybody that scoffs at it, all I say is look in the mirror and say, what are you growing?